doesn't want long-lasting power? I do, and I'm sure certainly you do too. Now here's a healthy tip for those who are always forgetting to eat their breakfast. Something fast, something easy, something highly nutritious that could actually save your life and maybe even save your job. The saying goes like this, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. And when it comes to women's health, the number one health risk for women today, all over the world, is breast cancer. We're here with Dr. Archie Lamadrid, who's going to teach us just how to be wary of this illness and how to prevent it. Hi, Doc.
Hello. Good afternoon.
It is scary because the numbers are growing and increasing. Mm-hmm. The number of women that are dying of breast cancer. What would you suggest or advise to women who are watching us right now?
The number one thing that patients should be aware of or should do is to be aware of breast cancer.
Yes.
And they should understand that breast cancer starts as a lump.
One little lump.
Yeah, one little lump.
Okay.
So if they are aware of that, they should do self-breast examinations.
Okay.
That's the best thing that a patient could do.
Do scary.
Periodic self-breast examinations.
Mm-hmm. So what would the protocol be?
All right.
It's a way of life for women.
Okay. The lifestyle is an important factor in the epidemiology of the disease, they call it. The diet. And it's now accepted that a diet that is rich, that is free of fat and meat, lends to a lower incidence of breast cancer.
So you're talking then vegetarian diet.
Mm-hmm. Number two, the lifestyle. Cigarette smoking.
Drinking
of alcoholic
drugs.
And drugs. And stress is a very big factor in the causation of any cancer for that matter, any stress. Mm-hmm.
So you do agree then food should be your medicine as well, right? It's what you eat that could affect your health and your health profile.
Sure.
So what are the major food groups that you would suggest for people to have as a form of balance and guide?
Oh, okay. Unlike the present diet of the Filipinos, which is all tilted in favor of the carbohydrates. We should have a balance between carbohydrates, proteins, and also fat, because we need especially the essential fatty acids. So I think taking too much of any of this would also be harmful.
Mm-hmm.
There should be a balance between the three, carbohydrates, proteins, and fat.
Research from a leading university in the United Kingdom shows that a high fiber diet, or at least 30 grams of fiber daily, can cut the risk of breast cancer by up to 50%. Do you know that most people all over the world skip breakfast, and that seems to be and is the most important meal of the day? So if you're one of those people who's guilty of skipping breakfast, think about doing something easy that will not waste your time, because people are always in a hurry. They say that this kind of age that we live in today is called the age of hurry, or people always in a hurry. The simplest thing to do and the easiest way to do it is to get oatmeal that's easy to cook. And then you would like to add more nutrients, pack more nutrients into your breakfast. And the most delicious, nutritious vegetable that you can add to your breakfast, especially your oatmeal, is broccoli. Broccoli is so high in antioxidants, it can actually and literally save your life. So, I will demonstrate something very easy that will take maybe only, 1 minute of your time? Let's put some oatmeal. Of course, we're going to use oatmeal that's fortified with folic acid. And remember, folic acid is brain food. Your brain cannot function without folic acid. I have placed about 4 tablespoons of Quick Cook Golden Oats Plus. All right, it's plus because it's fortified, And then we're going to mix it with a little bit of hot water. Now, I like oatmeal a little watery, but there are those that want it just thick, nice and thick. So there, I made mine a little watery. Here you go. Now, you don't want to overcook your broccoli. Remember, this is fresh broccoli, already washed. And then, this is the last thing we're going to put on our oatmeal because you don't want this overcooked. You don't want to kill the enzymes. So here we go. We've got the oatmeal. It's ready to be eaten. And then we will add the broccoli. You're not a broccoli person? Well, you can always add something else. Because I love vegetables so much, I placed more than a handful of broccoli. There you have it. Nutrition made simple, courtesy of Golden Oat. So, eat up. If you want a stronger body, take your broccoli. If you want a body that's stronger but has a lot of fiber in it and more energy, then take your broccoli with oatmeal. So here we are. We prepared the healthiest of breakfasts and the easiest of breakfasts, oatmeal with broccoli. Because we placed the broccoli last, you can taste the crunch. And remember, the secret of broccoli is in the crunch.